Hi, everyone. We're going to do a little short, well, not a short, but a social cam video. The other day, I posted a video of my aunt and I cooking in the kitchen, so I thought we should bring her husband, my uncle. His name is Chef Rickey. He's a professional chef, and today he asked me what I wanted to eat. I said I like Eggs Benedict, so he's going to cook Eggs Benedict and teach me how to really do it, because I go to these high fancy restaurants to get Eggs Benedict. I don't do all that stuff. So he's finna cook it, he's finna show me. We're having potatoes with it, I think, and mushrooms or something like that. But anyway, we'll see how it goes. So come on in, and let's
cook
with a little jazz music.
All right, now.
And here he is now in the kitchen, preparing. Let's see what's going on over here. Those are potatoes. It looks real easy, but only a real chef can make potatoes look real easy to be cut. In the pot, there you go.
In the pot, there you go.
Look at that.
Yeah, I would have lost a finger.
I would have lost a finger.
I feel like we have some fancy restaurant.
I know.
Music playing.
Music everything. In a minute. I don't have a key. So I'm learning, guys, all at the same time.
You know what? I just noticed. Chef Rickey brought his own utensils. Now, that's professional.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Those are not the utensils that we've been using.
How many people?
So now, are we allowed to say whose cooking was the best from yesterday to today?
Well, I'll tell you off rip. She said,
I'm not no Uncle Rickey, but I learned from him.
Well, that spaghetti was slamming, though. It was good.
It was.
Very good.
You know how long it takes me to cut one potato up? A lot of minutes. Are you catching that, y'all? Are you catching how he's cutting it up?
That's the part I can't do.
The cutting.
The chopping and the dicing or whatever? No. I get to go up fast like that. Lose a finger.
It's even better when you do your onions. Oh, wow.
Playing here. Oscar Peterson Trio. Well, that's some serious jazz. Oh, Forrest, you're going to be next. Chef Forrest.
Buddy in on this.
Keep the buddy in on.
That calls it together.
Okay.
So when you chop it.
There's a method.
There's a method to the onion cutting, guys.
Or you can just, if you want a slack sliver. And you separate it.
Wow. Got that?
Then you pull this out and use all your onion.
Oh, wow.
Don't throw none away.
Don't throw nothing away. That was that fast cutting, y'all. You seen that?
You got that good old chopping board.
Sure.
No, I know. I'm saying I didn't know there was raised ones. I was using the flats.
Oh, yeah.
The flats is okay, but you have to put a wet towel up underneath to keep it from sliding.
Oh, okay.
Knife set. It was free when you buy the knife set.
Really?
Yeah. Good old bar.
And then when he gets finished, I'm going to have him explain the knives and what knives to use during the cooking method, because I even took one of them knives to open the box.
You never use a knife on a box. You just bought those?
Mm-hmm.
Good, yeah.
Okay. Now, never knew how important the knives were when you're cooking. Don't use it to open anything. He said, never use a knife to open a box. I never knew, but I'll take it real quick.
For real.
Because paper is the quickest way to do a knife.
Oh, wow.
Wow. Knife.
Never knew that.
Paper is the quickest way. My knife passed the test. So how long have you been cooking on the radio?
Since 1900. I was 6 years old.
Wow.
Professionally since 1980.
Professionally since 1980.
Do you remember what your first meal was in my ethics?
Fried chicken.
Fried chicken.
Sorry. Sorry, Nick.
Doing
nothing.
Now,
you know. Fried chicken ain't easy.
Nothing, man. And clean as you go. Clean as you go. Wow.
Now, that's something I always, as little as I could, but I hate to mess up.
Yeah.
I have to clean as I go.
Wow.
Now we're going to get ready to separate some eggs.
Separate.
Separating eggs, guys.
A big bowl. I'm thinking I may have one.
So you're separating the yolks from the whites?
Yes.
Wow. Wow. That's something to learn, because I never...
I just moved in here, guys. I don't have all of the things yet. Everything is still in Texas. I got to bring all. I have big bowls, little bowls, small bowls, midget bowls, giant bowls.
That's the only one I have. I can put this in a bag.
One of those Ziploc bags.
I just wore all those bags that they must put in
there. No, they're right here.
Little onions. And the eggs. Some potatoes, though. Potatoes simmering. This is butter?
Mm-hmm.
For the hollandaise?
Mm-hmm.
Ah.
couple of methods. This is what I find easier for me. Always wash your hands, crack the eggs. Wow. Okay? Because we only want the yolk.
Only want the yolk.
See this?
Yeah. And you know what? You ever see in the store, they sell those egg separator things? It has like the perforations at the bottom.
Oh, I didn't know.
And all you have to do is use your fingers. Who would have thought? I would have been buying one of one of those gadgets.
Gadgets.
Right.
And by the way, if you did notice, he's cracking the egg with one hand.
And that by itself is... I'm gonna smash the whole egg. Save it. It didn't even break. Amazing.
I'd have been like, well, that's gone.
That may be enough.
I may want two.
Hmm?
I may want two eggs, Benedict.
Let me do one more egg.
Okay. I bought tomatoes. With that, could I have a tomato on mine?
Mm-hmm. You can actually have tomato instead of the English muffin.
No, I ain't got that yet. A lot of juice.
Now,
it,
you know, what's good with tomato is a crab cake, Benedict.
Oh.
You get tomato, crab cake.
You know, now that sounds good.
Yeah, here I am falling in love with just regular eggs in it. Crab cake. Next. Okay, so you don't have a whip for this.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I bought mine if you did.
Okay, well, it's not in the middle.
That's it. Okay.
I can pour it in a...
No, what I need is...
Part two.